Home remedies for breast infection. Mastitis is an infection of the tissue of the breast that occurs most frequently during the time of breastfeeding. It can occur when bacteria, often from the baby's mouth, enter the milk duct through a crack in the nipple. Breast infections most commonly occur 1 to 3 months after the delivery of the baby, but they can also in women who have not recently delivered, as well as in women after menopause. Other causes of the infection include chronic mastitis and a rare form of the cancer, which is called inflammatory carcinoma. Chronic mastitis occurs in women who are not breastfeeding. In postmenopausal women, breast infections may be associated with chronic inflammation of the duct below the nipple. Hormonal changes in the body can cause the milk ducts to become clogged with dead cells and debris. These clogged ducts make the breast more open to bacterial infection, and infection tends to become after treatment with antibiotics.
Don't forget to like, share and comment on the video. Also subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon for more updates.
Number 1 is apple cider vinegar. Another excellent home remedy for mastitis is apple cider vinegar. Its antibacterial and anti-inflammatory properties helps to reduce the inflammation, fight infection and prevent it from spreading. It also offers an added energy boost. Prepare a solution with 1 part of the apple cider vinegar and 2 parts of the warm water. Apply the solution on the affected area and then using a cotton ball. Allow it to sit for 15 minutes, then rinse it off with warm water. Repeat 2 to 3 times daily until the infection clears. Mix 1 tablespoon of the raw and fatal apple cider vinegar and a little honey in a cup of water. Drink it 3 times daily for about 1 to 2 weeks. Number 2 is fenugreek seed. According to the Ayurveda, fenugreek stimulates the milk production gland and at the same time helps to treat the breast infection. Plus, it is flavonoids that help to reduce the inflammation and infection. Soak 4 tablespoons of the fenugreek seed in the water overnight and the next morning grind the soaked seed into the paste. Place the paste on a clean cloth, warm it slightly in the microwave. Now use it as a warm compress on the infected area and repeat this remedy twice daily for 1 to 2 weeks. You can also drink a cup of the fenugreek tea 2 or 3 times a day until you get positive results. Number 3 is aloe vera. Aloe vera has natural healing power and pain relieving properties that can help to reduce many of the discomforts of the breast infection. It also helps to repair the damaged skin cells and heal infected tissues of the skin. Extract the gel from an aloe vera, apply the special on the affected area, allow it to dry on its own, rinse it off with a lukewarm water and with the dry and soft towel. Repeat several times a day for a few days and wash the aloe vera your breast before breastfeeding your baby. Number 4 is calendula. Calendula can provide relief from the pain and swelling, two of the most common symptoms of the breast infection. In addition, its antibacterial properties help to get rid of the bacteria causing the infection. Prepare a paste using equal amount of the calendula flower and camphor leaves. Slightly warm this paste before applying it to the inflamed breast. Leave it on for 15 minutes, then rinse it off with warm water. Follow this remedy 3 to 4 times daily. You can even apply a calendula ointment onto the affected breast a few times daily. Make sure to wash the breast with lukewarm water before feeding your baby. Number 5 is eat food with vitamin C. Vitamin C helps to fight the breast infection and heal the damaged tissue. Moreover, this vitamin boosts up the immune system and helps to speed up the recovery. Eat vitamin C rich food like oranges, lime, lemon, kiwis, guava, papaya, strawberries, kale, mustard green, broccoli, parsley. You can also take the vitamin C supplements after consulting a doctor. Massage. When suffering from the mastitis, massage the affected breast. This will help to unblock the plugged milk ducts and relieve the swelling. Always massage from the outer breast towards the nipple in the small circle, applying more pressure on the infected area. Prepare a massage oil by mixing together equal amounts of apricot and beet gum oil. Use it to massage your buzz using the upper spokes. Do this a few times daily. Another option is to mix a few drops of camphor oil in the 2 tablespoons of the olive oil and use it to massage your breasts a few times daily. Make sure to clean your nipples with warm water before breastfeeding your body. Hot and cold compresses. Both hot and cold compresses are useful in treatment of mastitis. While a cold compress can help to reduce the swellings and relieve the pain, a cold compress helps to clear the blockage, improve blood circulation, and aid in the milk flow. Prepare a hot compress by wrapping a hot water bottle in a thin towel. Prepare a cold compress by wrapping a few ice cubes in a thin towel. Now place the hot compresses on the infected breast for the 15 minutes. Next, apply the cold compress for 5 minutes. Repeat the cycle for 2 to 3 times a day. Use this remedy as needed. Cabbage leaves. Cabbage leaves are a soothing remedy for inflamed, infected breasts. They contain sulfur compounds that help to reduce the inflammation and swelling. They can also provide nothing mother relief from the encroachment and clogged duct. Chill a few cabbage leaves in the refrigerator for 30 minutes with the cold cabbage leaf on the infected breast. When the leaf reaches your room temperature, replace it with another cold one. Do this a few times daily until you get rid of the infection completely. Garlic. Another home remedy for the mastitis is garlic, which has a natural antibiotic property. It helps to get rid of the bacteria causing the infection. In addition, it boosts up the immune system and promotes quick recovery. Eat 2 raw cloves of the garlic on an empty stomach. You can also eat a few more throughout the day. If you do not like garlic, have it mixed with orange juice or plain water. Repeat daily for a week. Another option is to take garlic supplements, but not after consulting your doctor. Echinacea. The herb Echinacea bolsters the immune system to help the body fight infection. It contains the flavonoids that help antibiotic, antimicrobials, and anti-inflammatory benefits. Apply the tincture of this root on the infective area 4 to 4 times a day. Clean the area throughoutly with warm water before feeding your baby. Alternate 3 to 4 drops of the tincture to a glass of water. Drink it 3 to 4 times a day, and then not more than 4 days per week. Avoid long-term use of the herb. Additional tips: wear comfortable loose clothing to avoid the friction against the nipples. To reduce the risk of mastitis, keep the nipple area clean and dry between feedings. During breastfeeding, make sure the baby properly latches onto the breast. Ensure complete drainage of the breast by changing the baby's position during each feeding. If required, use a breast pump to empty the milk from your breast. Nursing mother should be kept proper rest and sleep to reduce the risk of infection. Avoid lying on the stomach as it can affect the milk flow in the breast. Drink plenty of the fluids to keep your body hydrated and keep the milk flow steady. Do not allow your baby to use your breast as a pacifier. Avoid surprise as much as possible to prevent the complications. If using nursing pads, replace them frequently to ensure that they are dry and clean.
Thanks for watching.